The anti-personnel improvised explosive device killed more Canadian soldiers in Afghanistan than any other weapon. I have a solution to this problem. Over the next 3 minutes, I'm going to characterize the injury pattern of the IED for you, tell you about a technology we've invented to try and treat these patients, and talk about how it can be used at home here in London. We looked at 100 consecutive patients that were injured by IEDs in Afghanistan and treated at a combat hospital. 70% of these patients had multiple amputations, some losing all four limbs. But the way they died was non-compressible hemorrhage. The blast broke their pelvis, injured their soft tissues, and made bleeding we couldn't put a tourniquet on. There is a technology called REBOA, where a wire is inserted into the femoral artery, up to the aorta, the main blood vessel of the body, and a balloon is put over that wire and inflated like an internal tourniquet. The problem with this in a combat environment is it takes an expert to put this in, an X-ray to tell me where the balloon is, and putting a stiff wire through an injured blood vessel can be difficult or dangerous. It can make the injury worse. We've developed a technology where a balloon's inserted into the femoral artery. It's inflated and expands like a party balloon up to the aorta, blocking blood flow as it goes. If there's an injury to the blood vessel, the balloon fills that hole and it keeps going. It's safe. If you overinflate the balloon, it'll rupture before it injures the blood vessel. But could it be used here in London? We looked over 5 years at all the vascular trauma patients here in London. There were 127 of them, and there was a 9.7% death rate. We can do better. 29 of those patients had injuries to their abdomen or pelvis that could be amenable to this technology. We have a therapy we've developed that is safe, easy to use, could be applicable to a combat environment, and could be used here at home. It will save lives.